Rona Cameron. John and Rona are pretty special because they come from here. First ones on the dub box tonight. Let's say hello to their new son, Ian. He was born in the best place to be born, Ayrshire Central. I'm trying desperately so much not to leave people out of the new bus this week. There's Brian and Alison Wallace from here. There's Kenneth and Diane Wells, also from Ayrshire's principal town. Hello to Ryan Andrew Wallace, to Bernadette and Ian Hamilton. They're from Ardrossan. They had a wee boy called Mark this week. And last but not least, can't forget special people. And they're delighted to announce the birth of their new daughter, Kirsten, at Ayrshire Central Hospital on the 3rd of August. Hope you're still in hospital, Kirsten. Hope you're having a nice time. And I hope we're playing music to fit in with your every desire. Got one here for all the new mums, all the new babies, from 1976. Paul McCartney and Wings. Picasso's Last Words. Love this song.
Grand old picture down last night.
Is that thing loaded? Well, basically this is strictly formatted radio. Community free. Community commercial free radio. 7 days a week. 365 days a year. This is the main playlist here. This is down here, this is the turntable number two. Sometimes works, sometimes doesn't. This is number one, and I'm going to have to queue up the next record just now, because I'm drastically running out of time. I was on the program when Grover Washington's next. Grover Washington is very popular in Kilwinning. It goes down well with all the... I heard that there was a lot of gay plumbers in Kilwinning. Just excuse me 1 minute. We cater for all tastes here at HBSA. French records and other things that come from France. From the album that went down like a burning Spitfire, Wings Over America, a triple album set. The only reason I played it is because I got one for my birthday in 1976. But we're totally cosmopolitan here on the Dirt Box with me, Peter G, in only 2 minutes before 10 on a big all music Monday.
Hi, my name's Mary Ellen O'Brien. I have a program on Sacramento, California's 93 Rock. One day I invited Peter G into my show. I'm not saying you ruined my career prospects, but now I'm answering the phones.
Oh, it's not true. Just because I wouldn't buy her a drink, that's all. That's all we've got on the show for you tonight. I'm afraid, 2 minutes before 10, leave you with Grover Washington. Broadcasting starts tomorrow here on HBSA at 8 o'clock, 8 through till 10 with John and Mail. See if you can check us out then. Bye-bye.
I see the crystal raindrops fall and the beauty of
it. And that's all there is to it. Another one in the can. Right, basically this is the HBSA studio number two. It's a bit like a shoebox. This is the ceiling up here, which needs obviously a whole lot of money, to get redecorated. You can see the time coming up here, it's 10 o'clock. 10 o'clock in HBSA at night means that we switch over to Radio Clyde. I've got to just listen to it through my headphones here. And the adverts are playing, so we go across there in about, or you can see about 90 seconds. The big clock on the wall, the thing that no one pays any attention to whatsoever. Just see that is actually, this film was actually recorded on Monday the 10th of August. Before we brought the camera into the studio, we extensively cleaned it up. We wiped the beans off the turntables. We got the curry off the walls. We got some window lean. We cleaned up this little So you can see that the place is pretty well soundproofed. We've got the phone lines right into the studio here, as you can see. We take calls in 76006. Unfortunately, we cannot pay for the calls. A lot of people try and phone us up here. We've got a lot of crank nurses phoning us up, trying to reverse the charges. I think we'll just get over to the news here. There we go. Another successful changeover. Unfortunately, Radio Clyde to this date have not fully appreciated the fact that we are actually a bigger station than they are. They always seem to take over at 10 o'clock for some reason, I don't know why. I would rather it was Radio Moscow or something like that, but well, it's here, sure, isn't it? He says he wants an inquiry so that there won't be. Hospital Broadcasting Service here, Sharp. HBSA. What could possibly be said about this station without bringing back capital punishment? This, as you can see, is our usual example of a programme schedule. No one takes too much notice of it because they tend to think people around here are rather silly. Which I can't understand. When you look at the amount of records we have in this place, over 5,000 individually catalogued and listed singles, ranging from all aspects of the musical spectrum, from Sidney Devine at one end to Einstein Newbarton at the other. We have country and western albums, Scottish albums, modern male vocal albums, and for the kiddies and most of the presenters, children's albums as well. Basically, all of our records are donated by Cunningham District Council, the library department. We are given some by people who no longer want their collections. Sometimes we find them in buses, other times we're standing in the bus stop having a quick winch and we come across the latest Daruti Column single. Over here you can see we feature a resplendent collection of 78s. Unfortunately we can't play these at the station because we don't have a 78 rounds per minute record player, unfortunately, and all the ones I pick out, as you can see, are 45s. Not to worry, we move on along across the studio library and preparation area, and we can see this fine 1955 example of a Xerox photocopier with a can of 1987 Diet Pepsi, 100% Nutritaste Diet Pepsi. And if we go through these extensive studio complexes here, we can see no smoking in here, it's the kitchen. We find a brand new gas-fired boiler, probably around about 75,000 BTUs, given to us very, very kindly by all the nice blokes over at the Isernan Health Board. Now, as this is the kitchen area, what kitchen is complete without the fridge? Let's have a look at the fridge, shall we? Close in on the can of Fanta. That has been there since round about 19, I would say, let me see, sell by, oh, what a stink, sell by November 1976, so we're saving it up, we're going to sell it off as a relic. The store in here is definitely a no smoking zone, because the studio manager keeps all his dirty books in here. Out of the kitchen area, and I must push it out, we run through to the other side of the preparation area here. And we go back into the reception area and box office, where we prepare to take credit cards from most major credit card companies, Access, Visa, Luncheon Voucher, and the co-winning round table. We have the main mixer here, which monitors basically the outgoing signal to the three hospitals which we transmit to, which are, of course, Cross House, Ravens Park and Ayrshire Central out the window there. We have a typewriter here, but the trick is, it doesn't actually work. The ribbon has been in there since 1968, as has this very, very old telephone exchange. No point in dialling the emergency services on this one, folks. Round the back, we have a beautiful weighbridge. Don't fancy holding that up on a cold day, which weighs the coal lorries as they trundle their way through North Ayrshire up to the port of Fairlie. We have the coach stand here, pretty art deco, around about, I would say, 1946. That was a hand in front of the lens there just now, not something obscene. And we're missing two of the little knobs off two of the prongs. Out into the actual area out here, which is the reception area in true of HBSA, we can see all the different little stickers and things, none of them whatsoever have got anything to do with hospital broadcasting, apart from this one here which says Hospital Radio Open, which is in fact a blazing lie because it closed about 15 minutes ago. Through here we have Studio One. Keep your distance, you're into a no smoking zone. Can you hold on a minute and I'll go get the keys and I'll open it up for you. Don't know where the keys are. Who's got the keys? Peel out here. Here we go. Never let it be said. Into the new studio. If we can get the right key. Here we go. Lights on. This is probably the pride of HBSA. This is Studio One. As you can see, we have special mood lighting so that the presenters, when they do come in, can actually get the feel of the thing. You know, they can get down low, they can get the mixer when it will sit here and crank it right up, put it out to the three hospitals that we broadcast to. As you can see, this fake plywood type veneer top here was actually given to us free of charge by a local joiner. He said it was free of charge, then he sent us in the invoice for £425 plus VAT. We will call him Mr. X, but his real name is Ralph Muchie of 23 Blake Avenue in Girdletall. Thanks very much, Ralph. Thanks for nothing. Round here we have the wallpaper, which is pretty scabby, and who can forget the 26-inch colour Teletext television set, which was donated very kindly to us by Harris of Sockers. No name dropping here. Well, basically that's all there is to it. Hospital Radio, broadcasting to over 1,000 beds per day in North Ayrshire. Well, there you have it. A quick and brief perusal of a look round a day in the life of HBSA, Ayrshire's only classic station. But, like everyone else, all presenters have to go home sometime. So if you'll excuse me, I'll be off. Okay, take it away, Bob. Okay, there you had it. A quick, short and sweet, unexpurgated visit to HBSA, Hospital Broadcasting Service, Ayrshire. Well, at the end of any day, broadcasters down here still have to go home, so if you'll excuse me, I'll be off.
Right, go.
Well, there you have it. A quick, brief perusal of a day in the life of HBSA, Ayrshire's only classic station. But at the end of every day, broadcasters here still have to go home. So, if you'll excuse me, I'll be off.
Anything over there?
Well, there you have it. A brief, unexpurgated look at a day in the life of HBSA, Ayrshire's only classic station. But at the end of every day, broadcasters, even at HBSA, have to go home. So, if you'll excuse me.
I can't even go.
Which?
I haven't went to the Cold
Games.
Not to do anything, as a spectator.
I just have to go, please. I mean, this caravan can't even cut the side, doesn't it?
I didn't think.
Martin, it's Doogie. Oh, caravan. Then Martin said to me the day, no, hey, there's no room.
You couldn't spend that car, you know, the way we
said,
are.
Maybe we could take it up and leave it in the car park. The car park?
Thank you. Queen this Saturday at the Irving Cross. All the details in your Miramis supplement, which one received, I hope, last week with your local newspaper. And of course, out to the moor.
After Central Hospital.
The Hospital Radio Summer Fete being opened by Gary Marshall from Radio Clyde. And in the evening, a concert for you with the Alexander Brothers, West Sounds, Lou Grant, Company Policy, local band Savoir Faire, in concert at Ayrshire Central Hospital from 7:30. Tickets, a few available, are £2 each.
How was that, Ian? I looked at you that time, Ian.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me remind you that this Sunday afternoon from 1 o'clock onwards in the grounds of Ayrshire Central Hospital, the Hospital Radio Summer Fete and the opening ceremony at 1 o'clock by Radio Clyde's Gary Marshall. An afternoon of fun and games. Entertainment, there's the Irvine Youth Band, local majorettes. There's a walkabout a bit. See how fit you really are. And all takes place in Ayrshire Central Hospital from 1 o'clock onwards this Sunday afternoon. Here's the Village People and YMCA.
He wants to keep it for prosperity. This is so he doesn't have to do anything. I'm sorry, I'm doing the video.
Which is a good point.
Oh, I know what it is. He wants to catch Billy Wharton. Sorry, I'll move out of the way.
This is it. I mean, this is actually the first
Billy,
thing.
Billy, when did you start getting these sudden impulses to do this work?
When we'll get evidence against
Billy. Come on, Billy. Stop laughing and say something.
He would tell you to get lost if it wasn't for the fact that he's dependent on us to get a lift back.
Billy, could you tell us, why is the studio not ready?
Because I don't have the equipment.
I knew I'd get some words out.
I'm waiting a mixer.
Well, you'll go
you've got one here.
I gave John McMahon.
No, you've got a stirrer, but no a mixer.
No, a Kenwood chef.
We need that to wind the legs down.
Yeah, there's only one down.
Is it safe to wind it down?
No, Billy's at the back.
Cheers.
His beery belly is in the way.
First thing, first session.
John, I'm going to go, Marlon.
Is Margaret Gallagher back? Derry.
Guys. Aye, what a guy.
I should have brought my wetsuit for you,
but
it'd be really wet.
Well, tell it, well, wait a minute, we've got to
home in
this. Look at this beer gut here, boys. This is what we're looking at. We're going wide angle here.
You need.
Fucking right we will, man. Wide angle, let's home in this big beer gut here.
Zoom up, Pierce, tush.
Pierce? Give us some concerned looks. Yes, that'll do nicely.
Wide angle, wide angle, wide angle.
Wide angle, we're going wide angle, we're going wide angle. Oh ho!
Guys, get your dish.
No, wait a minute, I want to film this.
Zoom it in then.
Wait, Kev. Concerned looks.
Right,
how
much is it?
There we go once again, don't forget the Alexander Brothers, West Sound's Lou Grant's company policy.
Right, we're ready to draw.
Savoir Fair this evening in Ayrshire Central Hospital. Some tickets still available, priced £2 each.
Kev's head's in, my finger's getting sore.
West Sound's Lou Grant's company policy and Savoir Fair in the main hall here at Ayrshire Central Hospital. Tickets, £2 each.
Right, let's go, chaps. One in the dish. Oh, you missed again.
Come on.
Go slap him, right in the scone.
Aye, you couldn't hit
a monkey
in 10 yards. Go,
slide down. Oh, you're gammy. Did you get my best side?
Wait.
Oh, yeah. I didn't get any of that, by the way. You need to do it again.
Oh, yeah, man.
Take two.
That's an L2, isn't it?
Right, man, back in. The sodden look.
Right, there's the tilts.
Recording, fucking dirty man. Oh, we're well away here. I'm going wide angle on that ass, by the way.
Thanks for coming to Hospital Radio Fact. We want you to dig deep into your pockets this afternoon. We need every penny to run Hospital Radio for another year. So there's plenty of stalls. So you now welcome Irvine Pipe Band, and they'll pipe in Mr. Gary Marshall from Radio Clyde, formerly from Hospital Radio.
Give yourself a round of applause. Everybody up here, everybody give yourself a round of applause. Go! A bit louder. Go! They're here today, obviously, to raise money for the Hospital Radio Service, which is a charity service. So everybody, sort of dig deep into your pockets and try and spend as much as you can, because it's all going to a good cause. And basically, that's it. So have a good day and spend loads of money. And thanks again to the Devon Pipe Band and to everybody who's taking care of the stalls as well. Thanks a lot. Have a nice day. Round of applause. Thank you very much. What about the fee? How much did I get?
Right, hello. Hello, testing 1, 2. Now, in my little bag of goodies here, we've got some t-shirts. Could we have a quick... Woo! Is everybody dead? A quick... Woo! Now, we've also got some 261 teddy bears. Now, we don't want an ooh, we want an ah, right? No, I haven't seen it yet. How can you go ah? Here we go. You ready? No, a bit more sincere. Ah. Now, let's unravel the wee teddy. Here we are.
I don't want to come out.
Come out, come on.
No.
There we are. Actually, this is Clyde the teddy bear. Ah. Now, Clyde actually speaks, but what he needs is somebody to love him. Ah. Do we have any... Hands up all the girls here today that would like to love Clyde the teddy. A couple of guys over there as well, eh? Dodgy. What he's looking for is, well, somebody about that height who loves teddy bears. Look at them all going... Right, so we're looking for somebody around about that height-ish. Ah, here we go, here's somebody. Hello, what's your name?
Vicky.
This is Vicky, and what age are you, Vicky?
7.
Are you sure?
Yes.
How do you know you're 7?
Because it was my birthday last week.
Ah, round of applause for Vicky's birthday! Vicky, do you want to take Teddy home?
Yes.
Will you make sure you love him?
Yes.
What will you do to love him?
Take him to bed at night.
They start early around here, don't they? Actually, would you give him a goodnight kiss?
Yes.
Could you just give me a wee kiss just now to make sure that the goodnight kisses are all right?
No.
I was wrong. Am I not as nice as teddy bear?
No.
Aww. Have you got any teddy bears yourself?
No.
No? So there'll be no other teddy bears that will get jealous?
No.
What have you got then? Have you got a big brother, a wee brother, or any sisters?
Just cousins.
Will they not be jealous when they see Clyde the teddy?
They live in England.
Do they? Well, that's all right then. They can stay there as well, can't they?
Yes.
Exactly. Have you got a boyfriend?
Yes.
Where is he here today?
No.
Where is he?
He's at his gran's.
He's at his granny's. And do you love him?
Not particularly.
Vicky, the question everybody's asking at the moment is, have you actually kissed? What's his name?
Ross.
Ross? Not Ross King, is it, no?
No.
Oh, that's all right then. Have you actually kissed Ross?
No.
Have you held hands?
No.
What? How come you're going out with him then?
I don't go out with him.
Oh, I see, he just calls you up and he annoys you.
Don't know.
Has he ever take you for a wee dinner?
No.
No candlelit dinners?
No.
Well, I tell you what, you ditch him, right? And you take Clyde instead, eh?
Okay.
But you sure you've got to give me a wee kiss? Just a wee kiss on the tiny cheek.
Okay.
All right. Ah, there you go. Actually, Clyde speaks as well. Want to say a few words in the microphone? Well, you ask Clyde a wee question and we'll get him to speak, right? So you ask him something.
Hello, Clyde.
Hello.
Will he work at home?
Will you ask him? Ask him.
Could you please work at home?
I don't really know.
Clyde, just say that you'll work at home and keep it happy.
All right.
Ask him again.
I'll ask.
What did you say to him? How old are you?
How old are you?
I'm 7'2", because it was my birthday.
Did you get any cards?
No, not even one. Presents? No.
Nothing?
Nothing.
What a shame.
I need someone that'll love me.
I will.
Oh, I love you too. Give me a kiss.
There we are. Thanks a lot. Cheers then. See ya.
Bye-bye.
She's a star. Well, that was great. There we are. And I've also got, what have we got here? Right, we've got these 7 Up t-shirts as well. So what we'll do is we'll just give them out to some people here. We've also got some pens as well, some Radio Clyde pens. Now, these are for all the guys this afternoon with a checkbook. All the guys with a checkbook, hands up. Ah, look at this. Hands down now.
There's one there. Right, well, actually, if you've not got a checkbook, then all you need to do is bring out your Visa or Access cards and make sure you've got plenty of money in the bank to spend here. Anybody want a pen? Who wants a pen? Right, come up here. There. Have a pen. Thank you. He's expecting a kiss there for a minute, I think. Right, up you come. There you go. What's your name?
This is Adam. Okay, Adam. Thanks.
He's got an awful deep voice.
What's your name?
This is Jane. Hi, Jane. No, there's only one pen. Right, you're going to have to fight about it. Come. I tell you what we'll do. How old are you? You're 7. What age are you? You're 5. What age are you? 7. What age are you? 5. So we'll get 2 5s and 2 7s. Right, now, you're 5, and you're 5. Could you stand there? And you're 5, and you're 5, and you stand there, right? Who do you think we should give it to? This number one, a round of applause for number one. A round of applause for number two. A round of applause for number three. A round of applause. Oh, everybody got the same? Hang on a minute. I think we'll give you everything, right? I'll give you the whole thing. There we are. We've got t-shirts. So, who's the 2 7-year-olds? What age are you again? You're 7, aren't you? Right. Well, you get a 7, you get a t-shirt. A 7-up t-shirt for a 7-year-old boy. What age are you? Where's the 7-up? Where's the 7-year-old one again? Right. You get one there. And then you get a t-shirt and you get a pen. So everybody gets something. Is that all right? Right, well done. And the final thing we've got, do we have any trendies here this afternoon? Yes. Where's the trendies? Where? The posers. Right, come over here if you're a poser. I thought you said you were a poser.
I'm quite a poser.
How come you're a poser? Describe to me why you're a poser.
Well, basically, I used to know you, so that must make you a poser.
Wait a minute. Hang on, I'm just a bit on the way here. Did we know each other? When did we know each other?
At West End.
At West? Did we ever hold hands?
I don't think I should say.
Shh, no, don't say. Please don't listen. Right, okay, good. Anyway, I think for the poser, we will give you a 261 carrier bag. All right, how's that? Surprise. Give him a round of applause. Woo! Okay. Your legs cold or something? They're all blue.
Is that the posy image?
Oh well, that's it anyway. Hello, Mum. Right, so that's it. Well and truly open anyway. And make sure you spend as much money as you can for the hospital radio, because it is a good cause. And don't forget, actually, all the guys who do the hospital radio, and that used to be me as well, they all do it for nothing for the people lying in hospital. And actually, I was in hospital recently as well, and it's a great service. It keeps your pecker up as well. So well done to all the guys. And spend. All right, thanks a lot. Cheers. That's it. No more.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear your applause for Mr. Gary Marshall. Thanks very much indeed.
Going back in.
sure you'll find it.
I've got my
just in the other arena, about to start now.
So is your bum?
Whoa! Make sure these sponges are full of water, make sure they're saturated to the full.
And your
shots,
next.
Right, 8 shots, right? You've got 14 shots on credit. See if you can get the high score this afternoon.
Oh, that's a poet. Is it?
It's roasting.
Oh, you should take it, don't it. Of it.
I'm going to put a bit of this ice cream in it.
The cold wind helps.
Have they made a concrete or something?
I saw the ones we had last year.
Just a wee bit too hard.
This guy.
Hey, well, mate, how are you doing? You want to sing?
You're the sunshine of my life.
And my shadow.
Give us you're the sunshine of my life.
You are the sunshine.
That's your best one.
So I know you. I'll tell you what I learned. I know one. Wait a minute. What was that song I learned when I was in holiday?
Very last one.
The very last, Teddy, and this is the last one. Seriously.
Last one.
Start it up down. What?
I've
got a pound. £1 for the Teddy. Any advance on a pound for the Teddy? £2 in here, we have £2 for the Teddy. Any advance on £2? Any advance on £2 for this Teddy? We're optioning this Teddy down here. This is a Teddy, know this one. There. What are you bidding? She's just waving her bidding. Any advance on £2? £2.50 I heard £2.50 there. Any advance on £2.50? £3. £3 for the Teddy. Any advance on £3? £3 over here somewhere. I just heard a noise. Any advance on £3 for the Teddy? It's the last one. And these were all donated by A. Milne and Son, the Beach Park people. Right, any advance? £3 for the Teddy. Going once. This gentleman here going twice. Got the last one? Sold to the gentleman over there for £3. No, that's the ball. That's it. The tea tent. The tea tent is almost run out, so if you want to get some for the tea tent, go and get it. I learned a new song while I was there. I can't remember what it was now. Must have been good.
Thank you, Mrs. And come up there. If you want a Teddy, a hospital radio Teddy, off that marquee, right off the corner up there, if you want a hospital radio Teddy. Still the tea tent, there's the big wrapper over there. And that real friend wrapper, that's in front. That's right there, I think.
No, I'm not lying, the wind's new.
Jim's watch has stopped, it's a wee bit off of me now.
Shampoo in the actual bucket so it saves them washing their hair later on. We take all major credit cards this afternoon, Access, Bartley Card, American Express. We also take luncheon vouchers and Claremont Hotel vouchers from Kowinning.
Non-stop classic music, and it's all for free.
I was not.
So we need all the money we can possibly muster this afternoon. We've got Jim Seymour in front of the HBSA caravan, as you can see. Jim is actually taking requests. For
on,
50 pence, Jim will sing the song of your choice.
Come on.
We don't care. We can range from the Art of
Noise. Come on, Jim, you're trying to get me.
Please.
This is for the Minimus doll.
This is the way I do it normally, dress, by the way.
Never
mind, lads. Right, here we go. I click up and under here. Oh, there we go.
Oh, quick, Rob.
It bit me. Right. It's all the fives, 24.
Oh, your name in the back here.
Oh, right. Name in the back.
Hiya.
Mackenzie Crossburn Uplamour. There we are, Uplamour.
How you doing?
John, you want to mention? Where's my...
Ladies and gentlemen, the number is 24 and the name is Mackenzie from Crossburn Uplamour.
And I've gone home, by the way.
There's a telephone number, so we'll phone them up. It's for you. There we are, okay? If anybody's wondering why I've got these jeans on, it's because I got soaked earlier on and had to borrow them, okay? This is for, what was that one there for?
The doll.
Oh, it's for the doll. Right, this is for the bottle of wine. Well, the half bottle of wine then. We've been drinking, haven't we? The number is 7 and the name is Mary Nisbet. Is that you? It's a con. It's a Swiss. Fixed. You need to allow it because you've drunk half it already anyway. Staggering about there. Right, here we go. This is the box. You want the box of sweeties? You want the sweeties? Not too sure about that. Right, the number is 43 and the name is Jim O'Donnell. Jim McDowell, is that right?
Band.
From P Band.
Pipe Band.
Oh, the Pipe Band.
Pipe Band.
The B Band. Okay, I've been on some of that stuff as well.
Thanks very much, Dad.
Thanks very much.
We'll
hand you back down to Sexy John McBale.
Put you on a full short, just heeding shooters. Give me 3, 2, 1.
Hello, my name is Doogie Greenwood, and it's my pleasure and privilege to have been chairman of Hospital Broadcasting Service Ayrshire during the last year, up until our AGM, which was in April 1988. This is one of our grin and bear teddies, and as John has mentioned earlier on, we are obviously a charitable and fundraising organisation. This is one of the main items which we raffle throughout the summer period. We're out at various fetes, gala days, and up and down the country throughout the year, and we've got to raise quite a bit of money, because at the end of the day our main concern is the patients in our three hospitals in North Ayrshire. As you'll have seen from the studios, it takes quite a bit of money to run the organisation. So once again, I would ask, if you have any old records or any donations you would like to give us, then they're all very, very welcome, I can assure you. So once again, thank you very much. And I hope you have an enjoyable day with John Barber and his talk up at Hospital Radio. Thank you. Wait for the start.
3, 2, 1.
Hello, my name is Doogie Greenwood. It's my privilege to be chairman of Hospital Radio right here in Ayrshire Central. This is our grin and bear teddy bear, and he's one of our main items which we raffle at the various fetes and gala days up and down the country throughout the year. As John has mentioned, fundraising is paramount to our organisation. So therefore we've got to put a lot of time and a lot of effort in, because as you see from all around the studios, it takes a fair amount of money to run the establishment throughout the year. And of course, our main concern is the patients in the three hospitals in North Ayrshire. And if we want them to listen and enjoy our music, and hopefully it's therapy for them as well, then we must have reasonable equipment. And our studio number one has recently been refurbished at a fair amount as well. And also we have concerts which we put on right here at Ayrshire Central with top name stars. In the past we've had the Alexander Brothers, Lou Grant, Company Policy, the Tafton Lads, and of course our up-and-coming one in April, that's going to be a nice big accordion rally we have. And that's also for patients and for friends. So we hope that the patients will manage a nice evening out, accompanied by friends and a wee cup of tea at half time. So don't forget, if you see our stall at some of these fetes you may visit this year, then please give generously. We need the money, especially for the patient's enjoyment. So we'd ask you to dig deeper into your pockets. And of course, if you'd like to come along to some of our events in the evening right here at Ayrshire Central, then you're more than welcome. Obviously, see local press for details. Once again, thank you very much for your time. And from Glenn and Barrett and myself, I hope you have a very enjoyable and informative talk from John Barber today. Thank you.
I want to back away. New York, New York. Percy Pops up undies, if you want them. Medium. You look like medium. A couple of badges for you as well.
Hurry up. The man's going to
be there. So thanks for taking part.
Thanks for winning. A nice round of applause for Lizette Inglis.
Yes.
Thank you.
We're going to steal with Lonely Boy from Andergold 1976. We've got a few minutes to go before we go off here. And then we'll go back to the studio. But stay here to the end. It's fun.